Fashion and lifestyle content that will encourage you to be your best self. So if you're with that, you're in the right place. Today we have a wig review and I'm featuring a unit by Sensationnel from the Butta Lace collection. This is Butta Lace 10. This is the stock card. Now I haven't featured a Butta Lace unit on here in forever, probably since, I don't know, pre-COVID maybe. When I first tried the Butta Lace series, when it first came out, Butta Lace 1 and 2, I was not interested after those two units. This right here is not it. Come on now. What is this? I haven't been anywhere. They just didn't do it for me, especially unit 2. That was trash. And I don't even like talking down on wigs like that, but the fibers were just not up to par. However, I noticed as they came out with more units, it started looking better and it seemed like the quality was better too. I've been eyeing this unit for a while. I actually first saw it on Miss Chrissy's channel, so shout out to you, girl. And I had to get her, so I am so pleased with what I have here. I'm gonna give you some specs on the unit, my thoughts, and then I'll give you some tips about customization. Okay, so the hype about this Butta Lace unit is the virtual undetectable lace, HD lace, right? That's all the rage right now with synthetic wigs, and Sensationnel, of course, had to put their spin on it. The good thing about these units is that they're at a more affordable price point compared to Sensationnel's infamous What Lace collection. It's not a frontal, right? But it still gives you the lace that you would get on a frontal unit. On the stock card, it says it has ear-to-ear lace. It says it's pre-plucked, natural hairline, natural density, baby hairs, all that. And from what I could tell, like when I was installing the unit, it definitely had baby hairs, these like straight long bangs or something. I cut them off because I'm not a baby hairs person like that. The hairline to me was not pre-plucked. It was definitely giving me round. So if you were to wear this with the hairline showing, just know that you probably will want to pluck it some more yourself. I opted to wear this a little bit behind my hairline, and I know y'all saw me use the Sharpie to blend it and everything like that, and I'm pleased with how it looks. I know y'all also saw me go in with my CoverGirl foundation in the corner here just because I wanted to see what the lace looks like when attempting to blend, and I think it looks good. I think it blends pretty well. So for those of you who do decide to wear this to the hairline and don't have a widow's peak like me, I think you'll be happy with the undetectable lace. It's definitely on the ashier side, but at this point, a lot of us who've been doing this for a while know how to tint the lace, color the lace, make it look more natural and match our skin tone. By the way, I do have Butta Lace Unit 16, so look out for that review coming up soon. This is what the hair is looking like in the back, all around. You see me, okay? I would say it falls on me like a good 18 inches now that I've done some trimming. Before the trimming, I would say closer to 20. It did come with some layers, but of course you saw that I added some, and I'll talk more about that later. As far as my thoughts on this unit, I really don't have any complaints. I do like the curls that the units came with, but you know, I had to do my thing to it. I think the cap size is medium head friendly. I have a 22.3 circumference head. If you have 23 inch or larger, it might be a little bit snug for you, but I think with curly hair like this, I think you can make it work. I love where they were going with the style, the length. I haven't worn big hair in a while, and this is just giving me so much life right now. I'm trying to think of a con, y'all, but honestly, other than those bang baby hairs, I don't really have a personal con to this unit. The parting space, you know, they said wide parting space and they did not lie. I also like that the parting space curves here. I really don't like the straight back parting spaces anymore. I've become kind of picky about that since I've been wearing synthetic wigs. I really hope the curved situation becomes a regular thing with more synthetic units that come out. All right, let's talk about customization, because I think there are some things that you need to know. I've been cutting and styling curly synthetic units for 6 years now. So, you know, there are certain things that I can get away with doing, but for my beginners, I want you to listen to me, okay? When you are cutting your wigs, definitely make sure that you're giving yourself room for mistakes. I normally start at the top when I'm trying to make layers. When I have my scissors here, am I going all the way here and making a layer? No, I'm starting right down here at the bottom, snipping, and then seeing how it looks after cutting it. So please make sure you take your time with this process. I think this is the most important thing to remember, to take your time. I've received a lot of questions over the past, you know, 2 years or so when it comes to cutting these curly wigs, and that's like my biggest piece of advice, because I think it's easy to kind of want to rush through the process, but it takes time to make it look good. Honestly, these synthetic wigs do not come ready at the pat. If that's what you want, you're gonna have to pay a lot more money. So just know that when you have wigs under a certain price point, you gotta get your customization skills together, and your girl is here to help. Now the next thing I need you to know when it comes to customizing, right, is this parting space. I did make a mistake. I used this Wonder Lace Bond, right? I used it, I sprayed it down, used my blow dryer, and it was tacky. But then as I was doing the finger combing method through my hair, it started shifting. I was like, what the hell, what's going on? So I had to go back over with my got to be glue to re-adhere it and then apply this again. To avoid all that, when you're dealing with the parting space, I think it's best to dab a little bit of the got to be glue first before applying a spray adhesive like this. Just something that I've noticed, I think that it adheres better with wigs like this. Now when it comes to frontals, sometimes I do something a little bit different, I'll be switching it up, but for this wig right here, this is what I suggest that you do. Now the third thing that was really important when it came to customizing this unit is the finger combing. My goodness, this is something that you guys did not really see on camera. I was finger combing for my life. Literally, I was just raking my fingers through the hair all over this unit, you see? And I was a little rough with it, you know what I'm saying? But for my beginners, I want you to take your time. This is what I want you to do. I want you to scoot up to your mirror, and when you're finger combing, I'm not saying it has to be this thin, but when you're doing a piece like this, you know, take your time to break the piece apart. If this is the look that you're going for, take your time. It's okay if it takes you a half an hour, because this is the look that you will achieve. And as you get more comfortable, you can rake it like this. I also was trying to provide a little bit more lift here at the top, so I did go in with this spray and I sprayed it at the top, used my blow dryer to try to provide a little more lift. Honestly, I could use a little bit more lift, and I think it would require me shifting this a little bit more to the side and doing more of that spray blow dry action, but I'm actually content with the way it looks now. I think it looks really cute. This is definitely giving me like Janet Jackson If video vibes. Oh my God, 1993, take me back. I'm going, y'all want anything? I love this. But yes, y'all, be gentle with the finger combing. Over time wearing it like this, it's going to naturally start to look this way, but I wanted this look like right now. So that's why I spent so much time finger combing, so I can achieve this look for y'all right now. What do y'all think? Let me know in the comments. Girl, big hair don't care. I love it. I swear, ever since I got this little swivel chair from Amazon, I don't know how to act. just be turning left, right. Oh my God. But yes, y'all, I'm really feeling this. Definitely recommend this unit if you like big curly hair. Another thing I noticed, because I like bigger hair, but I don't like when it's too big, because I do get overwhelmed, and then that's when I start feeling like I need to cut tracks out. With this unit, I didn't feel that way. I was like, okay, this is less work for me. So if you are comfortable with this type of density without having to like take tracks out and whatnot, I think this is the unit for you. Yes, it does become a little bigger as you finger comb, but it's not overwhelmingly big, if you catch my drift. Overall, y'all, I'm very pleased with this unit by Sensationnel. I'm excited to try Butta Lace Unit 16 because I saw my girl Brittany in that unit months ago and she looked so killer in the natural color. So yeah, y'all. Bow. Where am I going tonight? Currently it is Thursday, it's almost Friday. And I feel like this should be like my happy hour hair. What do y'all think? Let me know. Also, shout out to y'all for supporting my try-on hauls. This dress that I'm wearing right now is from my Amazon haul. If you're interested, definitely check it out. This is the dress right here. But I had a ton of items from that haul. I've been getting a lot of great feedback, so I definitely think you should check it out. But yes, y'all, let me know what you think about this unit in the comments. To me, she's a winner. Go get her. Link will be in the description box. I believe it's like $38, $39 on Amazon. Normally Amazon prices be a little bit higher, but it's $38, $39 on Amazon. So go get her. And if you made this far, go ahead and subscribe to your girl. Tap that notification bell so that you don't miss anything coming up. Check out some of my other wig reviews and make sure you check the description box for a ton of information about my channel. Thank you all so much for rocking with your girl, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.